Today we are going to use Tinkercad to make a terrific Clicky Fidget turkey, so let's get cracking. We are going to start today's tutorial with a bit.ly. Please type bit.ly/tinkturkey and press enter. This takes you to a template image I have created. Of course, it's set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad: give a reaction before you copy and tinker. When you choose copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of the project I have created. If you look up here, you will find notes. Right now, it just tells you that the tutorial could be found there. Friends, this is an SVG. It has awesome fill modes. I have utilized these fill modes to make the outside for a Clicky Fidget before. We're going to do it a different way today. We're going to start by hitting outer line, and I'm going to tell you to set the number to 2 and press enter. I'm also going to bump up the quality, and I'm going to set this to round just because it's easier for us to trace. Now I mentioned trace. What that means is we're going to be using the sketch tool. Notice when I bring this in, I'm setting it right in a 20 by 20 grid, and you can see that dotted line lines up exactly in the center. If we zoom out now, we've got a good picture of our turkey. We are going to trace him in a moment using the sketch skills. If you've never seen the sketch features, you can always check them out here. I also want to highlight that this is where you find the updates. You can click through the screens. They've got tons of great information and fantastic animations. When you're done checking them out, simply hit continue to sketch. They are always here if you need to go back to them. Of course, if you prefer my tutorials, I'll have a bit.ly right here that you can check out as well. All right, so here's how we're going to trace this. I've got my sketch grid set to 0.1. That lets me get close to the outside edge of this brown shape. When I hit 2, I'm in what's called Bezier curve mode. So if I click right here and then I click and hold, I can twist this so it comes close to following that shape. Now to make our life a little easier, I'm going to hit number 1 to turn it back this way. Then once again, hit 2, so I can do the Bezier curve to twist that close to the outside of that shape. We just want to be close. Of course, the closer you make it, likely the cooler it looks. And then just continue this 1-2 twist all the way around the shape. I'm going to just speed this up as I keep repeating these steps. I will mention, if you get used to doing this two-handed, it does make life a lot easier. I've got my left hand clicking the numbers and my right hand twisting and making the new lines. And you can get pretty darn efficient at tracing whatever shape you want to build. I do want to highlight once again that these are extremely useful. Of course, I will show you that in a minute. When you're done, you can edit them. So where these are a little bit outside, I will just fix that later. Once again, if you make an oops, you can just fix it later. If these are ever in your way, you can shut them off right here. And then finish it like that. Real quickly, here's why we did this. We can now click on this and turn on the stroke. And we can also set it to the outside. So this is going to be the clicker fidget walls. It also has other sweet benefits, but I'll show you those in a moment. First, let's get in here and edit it. If you double click on these lines, you can click on any point and you could nudge it somewhere different. You can stretch the handles, whatever you need. Say I wanted this to be over here, so it's completely in the brown. These are what are called smooth handles. Notice they move together. I want to break them by hitting the number 3, and that way I can get this one back in where I want it. If you ever make a mistake, like I just double clicked that, you can do Control Z, and you can just adjust these so they do exactly what you want. Once again, I'm going to hit 3 right there, and I'm going to move that in just a little bit. As I look around my shape, I am really quite pleased with it. Even down here where these weren't quite where I wanted, I'm going to only adjust them a little. This straight line, I'm going to put number 2 so it becomes a curve. And notice I can easily twist that, but I do want to break this. So I'm going to hit number 3 so that way I can bring this handle back out the way I wanted it. This is one I'm going to break as well, or yes, I am going to break it by hitting number 3. That way I can get this one where it needed to be and that one right there. Once again, we're just making the outside of our fidget clicker right now. We're going to stay with a stroke width of 2. I do want to make this so that it has round corners and simply hit finish sketch. Now we can simply take this and change the height to 17, and we have the outside walls of our project. I'm going to take this one and I'm going to turn it back to that default. I'm also going to make it black just because it's easier to see. It does take a minute for it to snap, but once it does, we'll have all those awesome details just like that. I'm going to take this, put my nudge back up to something large. Let's go with 5. And I'm going to shift nudge it to the right 2 clicks. That way it's going to be in the exact place we need it in a little bit. I can now click on this one and do Control D and take the duplicate. And when I edit that sketch, I'm going to simply click on it and I want it to not have a stroke value. When we hit finish sketch, we're going to set its height to 12 and press enter. That is the inside of your fidget clicker. It is also going to be the top of the fidget clicker. Let's do Control D and shift nudge it twice. Remember we had that size 5 set so that it would show up. And we're also going to change the height of this to 4.5 and press enter. Now we need to adjust these walls so that this fit will not be too snug. This is one of the coolest tricks. Use the work plane and set it right here. We're going to do Control D and D to drop to bring that same wall up. We're going to turn it into a hole though, and then we're going to double click on this to edit it, and we simply want to make this adjustment. We're going to go in here and we're going to set it to center line. So that means right now this is 2 millimeters and it's going to cut away 1 millimeter so that there's room all the way around the shape. This is why we did all that work of tracing, because then when we come out here, if we shift select those 2 parts and do Control G to group, no matter what sort of project you are working with, you've just instantly got your custom fit set up. Check it out, 0.5 gap, where you know this fits exactly on the other side. How cool is that? Whether you're making a clicker or a light box, this is the trick that matters. I'm going to quickly put my work plane back down on the ground, W and click. Now it's time to align the hole and the cap. Now it's time to put the 2 holes to use. Once again, these were in the template, but let me show you how you can save them forever too. Simply click on the part, click on your creations. Once again, with it selected, hit create shape. When it loads, give it a name. I'm gonna call mine keyhole. I'm gonna lock the part size. It is a hole, and then simply save the shape. It'll show up here in a moment. There it is, and then do the same thing for the other one. Once again, key shape. I named it key cap hole. Make sure it's a hole, lock the part size, save the shape. So that way I can get back to these any time I want. Right now though, let's get this placed. I'm going to do shift select. L for align, make the turkey center the boss. I wanna go center, center, and I want it to be at the top level. Now, if we look at this, quite often, the geometry of these shapes has center a little bit different than I want. So I'm just going to make it how I want. I'm going to just use my nudge. Instead of 5 millimeters, I'm going to set it to 1/2. And if I do a couple clicks, I think that's a little closer to the center of this project. Now, I do need these to match. So I'm going to simply select this one, the one I just made, choose L for align. And of course, I want to align it to the center of this hole. But then I'm going to take this and this, shift select, and choose L for align. And I want to align it to the center of the turkey. So I've got them aligned in this row and this row. I'm going to group these quickly, shift select, Control G. You can see that is all cut in nice and groovy. I want to put these fun details up on the top. So I'm going to hit W for work plane. D to drop. If I look underneath, now you can see that hole. And then we're going to do one more bit of trickeration before we actually put this together. I'm going to tell you to set these cool details to 0.5. I've already got my nudge at 0.5. I am going to duplicate this by doing Control D. And I'm going to lock that one and hide that one. So I'm going to click on the one I can see, and I'm going to make it a hole. and I'm gonna do control down to sink it in a half millimeter. This ends up being a fantastic way to paint all of this. I'm gonna now grab these three shapes and do control G to group. It does take a moment to do a union group like this because it's cutting out all that fancy geometry, but you can see that's now all cut in. If we look underneath, you can see the hole as well. If I click on this and do show all, our second part of our turkey shows up, but right now, remember, it is floating. I'm going to unlock it, and then I'm gonna do control down arrow so that it is flush with our design. W for work plane. So we've now got our shape completely built, and then check this out. As a single piece, I'm gonna choose export. Only the selected two shapes, as an STL. In my 3D modeling folder, instead of turkey template, I'm gonna make this so it says turkey top, and I'm going to save the changes. All right, friends, let's bounce to Bambu Lab Studio and find it in our 3D modeling folder or wherever you put it, and notice it comes in as one color. This is what's so cool though. If you've got a multicolor printer, we can add the colors with the awesome paint tool. All right, so in here we can pick our colors. I have got brown, orange, yellow, and red. Let's see how we can make this work. We've got the paint bucket, and this is important, edge detection. So I'm gonna start by taking the orange, and I'm gonna paint these little tail pieces orange. So I'm just clicking inside each one of them. It's that quick. Go out here and I'm gonna do the same thing. I want the legs to be yellow. I'm gonna have the whole body be yellow and let the brown shine through, I think. Then I can take the red and I'm gonna paint up here. And I'll paint this piece inside. And I think I'm even gonna make that one red as well. Up to you on the little feather parts. I'm gonna go with red there. If you make a mistake, once again, control Z. And then finally, I'm gonna paint these red as well. Bang. We have just got a fun painted turkey, even though we made it in one piece. I'm gonna click here to close this, and then here is the coup de grace. Friends, if we take this little dude and rotate it 180 degrees, using the middle parts so they snap, you can simply slice the plate and have an awesome smooth print in about 39 minutes. Do note, if you get an error that it won't print, it is because this little guy is too far out. Simply grab it and drag it back into place. Once again, slice print, and in about 40 minutes, we are going to have a cool multicolor turkey fidget top. All right, so while that's printing, let's grab this part. Once again, choose export. We're only doing the selected shapes, and I'm going to export as an STL. Of course, save it in the 3D modeling folder instead of turkey top. This is going to be called turkey base. And save changes. As you can see, the top has finished. If we back up to prepare, I'm going to just delete this. And let's add that turkey base. I'm going to stay with the brown, which is color one. We can simply slice plate with our 0.20 standards. And in about 30 minutes, we're going to have the base for our Clicky Fidget. And here we are. Bang! Multicolor turkey. How cool is that? All right, so here we are. This is the awesome frame. Here is the top. Once again, these parts fit Cali keys. There's a link in the description so you can find them. Find the edge of the Cali key and simply snap it in. You'll hear it click. And then grab the face. It clicks in as well, and when you're done, bam, Clicky Fidget. As you can see, I printed it twice, just changed the different colors to see how they'd turn out. All right, so let's review a couple things here. First, we took the effort to actually trace this so that we could do that outer line and get the gap between these two parts. That's what makes this so slick. By us going wider than the original turkey that I imported, we were able to use this to cut in, and that gave us the parts so we were easily able to paint it in Bambu Lab Studio, which I think is absolutely awesome. I have had projects at different times where I made the parts too small. When you get them too fine, then the printer cannot actually print those colors. That could be a problem with the technique, but I think with any SVG that you bring in, if you do that trick where you do the outer line at two walls, draw yours bigger, bam, you're able to make these walls for light boxes or whatever you want, and it should be easy peasy. Quickly, I do want to say a word of thanks to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a massive shout out to my Patreon supporters. We are almost up to 300. It has a fantastic messaging area. You can ask questions, gain skills, or just pick my brain on projects you're thinking about. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, or add a comment down below, and finally hit subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.